place. That is injustice. I am not against their being reconstructed, but I'm against the fact that Southeast has also not been reconstructed. These are things that can anger the youth, the genuine youth. However, it does not mean that they will not take up arms against their nation or order Northerners, Southerners, Westerners, and what have you, to leave Igbo land. That would be irresponsible. But they have a right to say, don't go anywhere, sit at home. If you want to obey them.
My apologies, sir. If you just allow me to just come in here, you've talked about some of the repercussions that this is throwing up. But let's look at how this can be solved. If we look the way of education in the north, do you think that perhaps, as we have it in the western part of the country, we'll begin to see a sense of better conduct, if you can qualify it as that, in the north, if we go through education?
Well, I don't, yeah, oh, but let me take, because I had education in the north. You see, the elites in the north had it as a deliberate policy, though unwritten, to ensure that there isn't proper education in the north. Because if there is proper education, then these people can question the lifestyle of the elite. And if they question the lifestyle of the elite, they want to become the elite. And the elite does not want that. So they ensure that the kind of education we have in the West, like you said, and in the East, does not take place in the North. So that they have the massive number of people who continue accepting that it is God's will for them to be poor. It's God's will for them not to have the good things of life. There are some people who are destined by God to have that. They are not. So whatever crumbs that they drop for them, they should be satisfied with. So the issue of, if the North were to be educated the way the West and the East are, we will have less of this kind of nonsense that we're having. Because you cannot just come and tell somebody to go and send his own children to go and bomb themselves, for instance. They ask you, why would you say, let your child go first, then my own child will go after him.
But just quickly now, I mean, you don't seem satisfied with the responses that you've heard so far. What sort of response would be a satisfactory response for you?
Total condemnation. Complete condemnation. Not justifying it in any way. Not making excuses for it. Because if your father, my people say that he who his father sends to go and steal uses his door to break the door. Because you know who is backing you. When you first of all justify, oh, there's a reason really. There's a justification for this. Oh, if only the Igbo people stopped cautioning Nnamdi Kanu, this wouldn't have happened. Oh, if only you are giving justification for this thing that happened. And that will also make them tomorrow to go further. And that's what I'm not worried about, oh, leave my place. I'm more worried about what will happen when I don't leave that place. And it's going to happen. And then they will also come and say, oh, it's condemnable. We were supported. And you engineered it. They're actually complicit in this. So, I have a fantastic relationship with a lot of Northerners. Faisla was one who I call my younger brother in the House of Representatives. I have several of them. I've shared rooms and houses with them. So I'm not saying the North is bad. Of course I'm not saying that. But what I'm saying is that when things like this happen, it is the body language and the reading between the lines that encourage further actions on the part of the irresponsible youth. And irresponsibility is not only an exclusive preserve of the North. No, we have them in the East, we have them in the West. And I'm just using North, South, and, I mean, North, West, and East now, as we had them, had before. We have them all over the place.
So would you say that, with the responses that have been given now, people should feel assured that their safety is assured in the country?
Definitely not. Definitely not.
You don't feel that way?
I don't feel that way.
Why?
If I was living in Kaduna, in Kaduna, some of those places, by this afternoon, I won't be there again.
This is despite the assurance from northern governors?
Because there are assurance. They just made,
this is despite
this is the rhetoric where we are always, you know, if we start taking this more seriously.
Just a moment, Mr. Odidika, because what you're saying actually has very grave implications. I'm sure you know that a lot of people are watching you.
Correct.
And you also know that what they tried to do yesterday was douse the tensions and send a message home that, you know, people are welcome regardless of wherever it is that they live in this country. So what would you have wanted them to say to provide that reassurance? Because first and foremost, the government, the responsibility of any government is the safety and security of its citizens. What would you have wanted them to do?
No, but do you realize that immediately after the massive killing of Southeasterners in the 66, early 67, there was an assurance. Sorry, immediately after the killing, thereafter there was now more massive killing. There was an assurance. Oh, don't worry, it's under, what is under control? Some young people come to the symbol, Arewa House, and make such a statement, and we're hearing go and arrest them.
So if they're...
So stay back, don't worry about your...
That's the moment, if they're arrested, would that give you any assurance?
It's not just arresting. You see, arresting. What, do you know what arrest means? If you're suspected of committing a crime, I arrest you. Prosecution and jailing.
Is what you want to see?
Yes.
Well, that's where we'll have to leave it. Mr. Kenneth Odidika is a legal practitioner. He says he's first and foremost an Igbo man and a Nigerian. That's where we'll leave it on this segment for Sunrise Today. I hand now over to Chamberlain in Lagos.